Miguel will be guiding our Mayan site tours, which will be starting tomorrow. He is a Mayan cultural and leading authority on Chichen Itza and the Pyramid of Kukulcan. He is the author of several books on the Maya, including two on Chichen Itza. He was coordinator of cultural services for the Yucatan state government and the director of Chichen Itza for 4 years. Miguel studied for 17 years with Mayan elder Don Vincente Martín, who was a wisdom keeper, professional teacher, and artist. Miguel became a master in his own right, known as Master Nazul, and teaches seminars in Mexico and abroad on Mayan astronomy, philosophy, calendar, symbols, medicine, cosmovision, transition, and prayers, ceremonies, and healing. Miguel teaches us how to connect with the masters of light who are available to teach us how to connect, to teach us about the ancient times. He conducts tours to the Maya sacred sites so that we can experience firsthand, which we will be doing this week, the Mayan sacred sites, their powerful activation energies, and this mainly their powerful activation energies. They do have that. And once you fire them off and say go, whoa. His knowledge and experience make the journeys come alive as we begin to understand how the messages were imprinted, what the glyphs mean, how the buildings were used, and how the ceremonies were conducted. Miguel teaches a heart-centered style that connects rapidly and profoundly with all those who study with him. Those of us who experience him realize that we are in the presence of a master and are being given an extraordinary gift. Don Miguel Angel.
Hello. Hello, everybody. Well, first of all, I want to thank you to Cory and Robin to invite me here to this special event to share with you part of my experiences in the Maya land. But before to start with the conference, in our tradition, it's very important to ask permission. If I am going to visit any one of you at your home, the first thing to do is to knock the door and to ask permission. May I come in? I am a stranger. So in our tradition, the best thing, the main thing, is to ask permission. So now we are going to do this in presence of my two friends here. We're going to ask permission to the four cardinal points and the heart of the heaven and the heart of the earth. Corazón del cielo, el corazón de la tierra. Without that, then we opened the conference and we asked permission to the lords and the guardians, the masters of the light, to allow us all together to understand this transcendental moment that we are living as a humankind. So I invite Eric and Trudy. First of all, please stand up. One of the ways that I learned from the elders to respect this moment is to do this mudra and put right in your heart. This is going to be a moment of silence. And imagine in this moment, from the sun we are receiving in our seven chakra the light, connecting and giving us in our brains, in the third eye, this golden light who is descending now to the fifth chakra, to the heart chakra, solar plexus, second chakra, and third chakra. And then imagine this golden light goes down and to connect with the heart of the earth that the Mayans called the heart Grandma Ishmukane. In this moment, we're grounded this, and then we will do the most sacred salutation in the Maya. And then, in this moment, asking permission to the Creators of the Life, Father, Mother, He whose name is whispered in a breath. Breath in, breath out. Breath in, breath out. Breath in, and breath out. This is the Maya salutations to the Creators. He whose name is whispered in a breath, that essence of life who is in our body, soul, and spirit, and is with us now. Never forget it. That's the most sacred honor and salutation from ourselves to the Creators of the Life. Breath in, and now open your hands. And now we are going to do the salutations to the four cardinal points. We are going to begin with a symbolic east to the right, to the east. We invoke the masters, the spirits of the east, Inkaba, Lakinik, Kishkelenyum, please send to us the light to our hearts and to our minds. Please help us to receive the guidance, the wisdom, to follow the right path, and to awake our consciousness. Receive our salutations. To the west, Lakin, Lakinik, Inkaba, Lakinik, Kishkelenyum. We ask the lords of the west, Ek Chibchak, Ek Mukenkab, Ek Pawa. Lords of this side, please help us to do the inner psychological transformation. Now, this moment, please help us to release and to transform anything that is not in balance in our bodies, in our seven levels of energy. Please help us, the humankind in this moment, to come back to the balance with the heart of the earth, the heart of the sky. Please allow us to come back to the light. Receive our salutations. Then to the north, al norte saludamos shaman, Inkaba shamanik Kishkelenyum. In this moment we invoke the lords of the stars, our teachers from the stars, from Pleiades constellation, from Orion, from Sirius. We ask you, brothers, masters, send us in this moment the light to transform our brain in a positive mind, in a positive thoughts. Please help us to transform anything negative in our minds. Please help us, humankind, to do it. Please send the light to all humankind and to all the beings in the planet. Receive our salutations. We move now to the south, al sur, Incaba, Noholik, Kishkelenyum. Invocamos al sur, los maestros del sur. We invoke the Mother Ixchel, Mother Earth, the Grandma Ishmukane, Grandma Heart of the Earth, Grandpas Ishpiakok Ishmukane, and all the lords and all the spirits of the life, the Alushov, Yumsiles, and all the spirits of Mother Nature. Please be with us. Receive our love and receive our honor. Now to the heart of the earth. We honor now the heart of the earth. Grandma Ishmukane, Mother Ixchel Maria, Isis Insoberta, Minerva, the sacred feminine represented by all the goddesses. We love you, Mother. Receive our respect. Please forgive us for all this harm we have done to you. Receive again to your children in your heart. Receive our love. Receive our honor. We love you, Mother. We honor you, Mother. We are with you, Mother. Take care of your children. Now we'll come back to you. Receive our salutations. To the heart of the heaven, to the cosmos creators, to the givers of the life, Hunabku, Itzavna, Ixchel, Kukulkan, Tepehu, Gukumats, Hurakan, Shpiakok, Shmukane. Thank you for the life. Thank you for the love. Thank you for the abundance. Thank you for this breath. Thank you for all the elements of life. Thank you for this creation. Thank you for our Mother Earth. And thank you for all. Receive our salutation. Okay, thank you. And sit down. Yes. 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 I want to tell you to begin a special oral tradition. Why we find so much connections between the Native Americans, the Mayas, the Incas, the Egyptians, the Tibetans, and many other ancient tribes and the indigenous people, who we feel that we are connected is when we travel and we see Tibetans are very close of the Mayan rituals, and when we see a Native American is very close of the Egyptians, and it's like we belong to one specific source. Well, in the Maya, there is a legend. The legend said that before Atlantis sink, the ancient ones called three teachers. These three teachers were Lord Osiris, Lord Viracocha, and Lord Itzamna. There were the three teachers who were chosen to choose the right people and to leave Atlantis, the Poseidon Island, before the sink of this island. Osiris was in charge to find the people who knows, who have the gift to understand the mysteries of the life and death. And he went to Egypt with this group of people. Then Viracocha was chosen to find the people who knows how to manage, you know, how to transport big stones, how to use teletransportation and the power of the mind to move these big stones. He went to Peru, to the Inca. And the last one, Itzamna, himself, he defined his name like, I am the dew of the sky, I am the dew of the clouds. He chose the good people, the wise people. And he crossed from Atlantis to the Maya lands, now peninsula of Yucatan, with the good and wise people. When he arrived here, he decided to call this land with the name of Mayab, M-A-Y-A-B. And he said, I am going now to do something. He brought all the people, and he said, I'm going to do a question, because I need to know what is your gift, what is going to be your mission in this sacred land. And there was a big tree with flowers, big roots, and they said, think a meditation for a moment. Look to the tree and then do the action that you feel. So all the people in front of the tree were there. Some stayed without to move. Some goes and took a piece of the tree and makes like a weapon, like a stick. And another goes and takes some flowers. And another go and listen close of the earth, the roots. He said to them, the ones who took the flowers will be the artist. The seconds who took the piece of wood will be the warriors. The third ones who listen close to the earth will be the medicine men. And the ones who didn't move, they will be the prophets. That's one of the beautiful legends that you understand. Itzamna was one of the Atlantean teachers who came to the Maya lands. The Maya is a quite interesting word, M-A-Y-A-B. Ma in Mayan language means few. Yab, the land. The land of the few. The land of the chosen ones. Who is a Maya? A Maya is a chosen one. Why this person was a chosen one? Because he is her level in his heart, in her heart, to understand and to be in perfect balance, because the spirit, the soul, and the body. You could be a Maya, because Maya means a consciousness statement. Maya is equal to say Avalon, is equal to say Satori, is equal to say Nirvana, is equal to say Cielo, is equal to say Valhalla, because there are representations of levels of consciousness. What is your Satori inside you? What is your sky inside you? What is Avalon inside you? What is your Shangri-La inside you? What is your Maya inside you? So don't look outside, look inside. Because you have the sky, you have the heaven inside your heart. And all the teachers said, go in, look what you have inside. That's the answer to understand the mysteries of life, and as above, so below. So this is one legend that maybe you understand that we are the same now, in this moment, in this time, we are the same. We all came from one source, and we have the same challenges to save and to protect and to love and to honor Mother Earth again. This is our main and most important mission now. And people ask, why all this is happening right now? Connecting with the 2012 process, there is a beautiful message that is written in one of the sacred Mayan books that is called the Chilam Balam of Chumayel. Chilam Balam means the Jaguar Prophet. And the sentence said, that which cannot pass in 1,000 years can pass in an instant. It is enough that a god breathes and the course of the wind changes. Now is that time. Now God breathes, and all of us, we are in a big shift, in a big transformation of our consciousness. Why did the Mayas came to the temples in the Mayab land? The Chilam Balam said, because the land of the Mayab has light, a light that comes from below and goes diffusing through the night in order to supply with light that which needest. Because the land of the Mayab is sanctified since before it had a name. It is beneath today that in times very ancient it was above, and that is what gives light. Holy is the land of the Mayab. Where did the Mayans come from? What is the origin of the Mayan people? The masters said, also, they were not the same as the sun. From the jewel of the heart of the sun got down the caste of the good men. Although they were not the same as the sun, from the jewel of the heart of the sun got down the caste of the good men. May we respond in many ways why the origin of the Mayans is in touch with the cosmic, with the sky, and we all are the children emanated from the source of the sun. We are the children of the sun, and we are here now to share the Maya knowledge. There are three things to consider a solar culture. Three things. Solar culture, serpentine, connecting with the serpent, and phallic culture. phallic, solar, and serpentine. These three things you will see all around the Mayav, because it's the energy of the Kundalini arising through the serpent that happened in India, that happened in Tibet, the Nagas, the Kundalini, the Sapkant, the rattlesnake, the seven energies who we need to arise, our energies, and to connect mind and heart. So the Mayans call this power with the name of Kukulkan, Ku-God, Kul, veneration, Kan, infinite. The Mayans didn't know the word sky when they said, where is God? God is in the infinite with the word Kan. Kan means in Maya infinite. Kukulkan. Kan. So where is God? In the infinite. And when the Spanish came, said, where is God? In the sky. The concept now is limited. The Mayan said, where is God? God is in the infinite. God is in the cosmos. Okay, so now we're going to begin with this lecture. The title that I gave is Astronomical Phenomena Through the Cosmic Windows at the Ball Court at Chichen Itza. And I think that, as you know, through the Mayan elders, we studied together, especially the Maya Trocortesian Codex, and we took with 7 pages 12 years studying only seven of these special codex, who is now in Madrid, Spain, and is one that is considered one of the original ones who was safe, and because it's avoided the burning that Fray Diego de Landa, the Spanish bishop, did in 1562 in Maní, Yucatán. So this book is very long, it's 6.5 meters, and then you have enough information for 4 or 5 lives, because you find science, art, philosophy, and religion. The 4 pillars of one culture is to see the 4 pillars of the culture. I cannot understand a process of one culture only to see the science. I need to see the science, but I need to understand the art. What is the royal art who is transmitting to me, to the symbols, guide me my consciousness to another level through the color? And then the philosophy. What is the philosophy means is to understand that the philosophy express, you know, terms like astronomical things or connections with some herbs, with some trees, and specific ways to call, you know, for example, the word halach winik. Through the philosophy means the truly true man. Who is a truly true man? A halach winik, a complete man who is developed in his, her 7 levels of energy is considered a halach winik. A real man with science and love. That's us, the halach winik. Okay, so the cosmos for the Mayans was the Musa who inspired them to understand. You know, the Mayans said that the cosmos is the inspiration for them to understand, and is the symbol of Kaan, the serpent in the night. There was a goddess that is called Ishkanleosh. Ishkanleosh is the mother of the gods. And they represented the Milky Way as a serpent, the white road, you know, Sakbe, or the white serpent in the sky. Kinesh Ahau, translated means the Lord with the face of the sun. Kinesh Kagmo, precious bird, precious Mako, with the face, with the eyes of the sun. So they honor the sun as a giver of the life, and the eyes of them, these masks are in Cojunlich, Quintana Roo. I recommended that place. It is a beautiful place to visit with these many masks who represents the red color of Father Sun. Here, there is a page of the Trocortesian Codex. As you see, you find the science. You know, you see here the astronomy. You see here Mercury. This is the North Pole star. This is Jupiter, and this is Mars. But then you see the art in color, you know, with the blue color and brown and the different expressions, artistical expressions. Then the philosophy, who is represented, for example, with this is a sacred symbol for feminine. So it means that this man is doing an activity connecting with Mother Earth, who is considered the sacred feminine. And inside this egg, floating in the space, there is an astronomer with 23 eyes, who means that he has the ability to look in all the directions of the cosmos. So you can pass a lot of time trying to understand first the science, but then pass through the art, pass to the philosophy, meditate for some years, and then to understand one of these extraordinary books about the universe. It is it's magnificent that we have in Chichen Itza these serpent heads, but the most amazing in this figure is to see the spiral is in the mouth of the serpent. Serpent in Maya, you can say K-A-N, Can, who means serpent. But if you invert it, then you have Nak, N-A-K. Nak means in Maya limits, the limit of the life, the limit of the energy is in the mouth of the serpent. Everything flows in a way of a spiral. Now we know the physics said that everything flows in a spiral way. So now it's tested. How did the Mayans know thousands of years ago, 2,000 years ago, that everything flows and is connecting with the serpent, the movement, the spiral, and all the connection with life? That is the ball court that is considered the largest ball court in Mesoamerica. It's considered that this, for me, in my concept, is a temple where it's possible to do the inner transformation. And there are things that when I was there, watch, and one day I was guided for my inner teachers to take the photos that will show you how this happened in the past, how the Mayans used the astronomical phenomenons to teach to their people. So this is about, this is the field. This is one of the rings here and one of the rings there. And it's about 200 meters long, you know. I want you to see these remainings of these windows. There's one here, there's one here, there's one here, and one here, and one here. And this has a special meaning that I will tell you. But now I want you to situate, to locate the ball court, especially in this area. In the center of the ball court, this is the only one window who is still stand up. The others were destroyed by the time, but this is the only one who stand up. And I always call me the attention why that window, what represents that. With my teacher, we studied that probably that is the symbol that is connecting with the Xibalba and the two forces who represented Hunhunapu as the sun and Ixbalanque, the lunar forces, and both is the yin yang to become us, you know, the warriors of the light and to transcend the ego part and to get the other level of consciousness. So with that information, when I was working there, I had the permission to be there, you know, anytime. And I began to follow that the windows, this window is located exactly to the sunset and the equinoxes. And it means that if the windows are located the center, in the sunrise, the other window will show the sunrise, and that one who is sunset is located, you know, in a perfect alignment. So I have the window in the morning, sunrise in the afternoon, the sunset in the equinoxes. So March 21st is a long process that it takes 33 days to complete the process of the descended serpent. The feathered serpent descends to the earth in 33 days. Beginning March 4th with 6 triangles, then March 21st with 7 triangles, and finish April 6th with 8 triangles. And then from that, there is another that is connected with the zenith to now is connected with the Pleiades cycle too. So look what happened. The process begin in May 13. This shadow here, you see a little bit of them, there is the window who is projected in the floor, and it's about 5 o'clock beginning May 13. Now you will see more clear. The shadow here is the window that is going to touch the first ball player. We have 7 ball players in this panel. And the middle is the one who is decapitated with 7 serpents come out, you know? And then the shadow is there. So, you follow? Now you see the shadow. The window, very clear, is close. Going close. Now it's here. The window. Look. Is the shadow close of the panel? This begins to go up. This is between 5 o'clock and 6 p.m. Then you see how the light is coming to ascend. You see here perfectly. This is the window. Goes up. Look. So the light is beginning to shine the first t-shirt, the first ball player, who means that it's going to be a process during these days that each one of them is going to receive the light, because this is the symbol of the inner transformation in your 7 levels of energy. Look, now the shadow is perfectly aligned with one of the ball players, and this is the center of the ball court connecting with the skull and with the man who is kneeled, you know, sacrificing the ego. The Mayas never killed people. The Mayas didn't sacrifice human beings. These stories came from Mexico, Aztec people, but the Mayas didn't make it. This is one of the big tricks to keep us down in our consciousness. Maya said in La Quech, "You are my another me. How am I going to kill you? See, you are the mirror of myself. You are my another me. You are my brother. You are my sister. How am I going to kill you?" In La Quech, Alaken. So this is the process. Now the light, the window is shining, and now you see clearly. This is the ring. Exactly in this alignment, you will see the skull here, the man with the seven serpents come out as a symbol of transformation, and this is going to be like a screen who's going to move from the May 13 like this, and in May 27 is going to be an alignment between this man who is sacrificing his ego, the ring, and the window. So the Xibalba lost the game. And who won? Ixbalanque and Hunabku. They will become in the sun and the moon. That is the marvelous cosmic battle. That's why they invited them to play the ball court. Okay, so look. It's again. You see again clearly. This is the symbol of the decapitation. The window goes a little bit more. You see clearly now where is the window. Perfectly alignment. So imagine this in the ancient times when everything was in color. You see clearly the color, and in the moment when the light is passing through each one of them, to the seven players, is like the symbol that the sun is cleansing, transforming yourself in your seven levels of energy, becoming you in a new warrior, in a new teacher of the light, who is ready to teach, because then you get the pureness. You are again connected with the light to the sacrifice of the ego. The ego is something symbolic. The mystical death is necessary, yes. Because we need to be transformed in another thing. When we sacrifice our anger, we got the peace. When we sacrifice our envy, we got the philanthropy. That's the meaning of sacrifice the ego. That's the main thing that the Mayans insisted to us. And that's why all the Popol Vuh, you know, talks about this battle, who is precisely in the ball court when the Lord of the Xibalba invited the lords to come and to play. But look, the meaning of Xibalba, the real meaning of Xibalba, says this. Xibalba means the inner sacred fire to transform yourself. That is the real philosophical meaning of Xibalba. It's not the hell, it's not something dark, it's not something evil. There is just a story, the process that we need to understand. The important thing to be transformed in light. The battle between the yin and the yang. Precisely here you see the shade, but the light is there. And then it's clearly. So this is May 13, and the next day is this window is going to be in this place connected with the decapitated, and then connection with the ring. This is the closets that I took, the window. It's clear. And now you see very clear. There is one of the warriors there, the masters, who they are transforming himself in the water of the light. A new master is coming back. A new master is birthing there. That is the middle of the ball court. This is a symbol of the skull. But look, the skull has a ring. The skull is talking, what means that the skull is not dead. It doesn't represent something like sacrifice. Sacrifice the ego, yes, but not human physical sacrifices. This is the man who is kneeling, humbleness, to receive the decapitation in the seven levels of energy, physical, etherical, emotional, mental, will, consciousness, and innermost. We must dive in our seven levels of energy, connecting with the new birth, the second birth. And the ball players give us the lesson. This is the ego in the hands of one of the players, and this is the knife that we need to decapitate ourselves. We need to dive because it's the only way to live. If the seed doesn't die, we will never have trees and plants. So we need to transform inner us in order to ascend, to transcend to another life. And again, our parents in the Popol Vuh, Hunabku and Ishvalanke, help us to transcend the different tests, the different obstacles in our life, and to arrive again to the level of the consciousness. This is the symbol of the crystal skull, who is the symbol in the middle of the ball court. What means that we need to transform our mind in crystal, in light, in clear, in pure, to become the Christ, to become the Christus in this place. That is a symbol of the crystal skull. Christ, crystal, pure, clear, crystallization. The mind is the laboratory of the science. The heart is the laboratory of the innermost. Together, they make this. The eight. When I talk, this line crosses exactly in my throat. When I link my mind in balance with my heart, I speak wisdom. The Mayans were brilliant scientists. We are amazed with the calendar, but they were marvelous mystical people too. Science without love is not in balance. Science with love is in balance. That's what we need. Scientifics with big hearts, people of technology using for well to help the people in their own ways, to bring to the people who has not the possibilities to access to a better way of life, but bring them the wisdom, the knowledge, the understanding. That is, in concrete, there's the window that I show you with the phenomenon. The only one who is stand up. Look, the ring, who is represented the ball who needs to cross right here. And look, the alignment is exactly where the skull is connected. The skull, ring, window. When the light of the sun cross right in the ring is when the decapitation occurs in one person. And in that moment, the universe inside of the skull is there. This is the universe, all the stars, all the cosmos, the constellations, the stars, the planets, everything is what the Mayans put in this Mitchell Hedges crystal skull, was found in Belize, Lubantum, by Mitchell Hedges in 1927. And now it's in the United States, and it has been tested by many companies, and they said this is something amazing. If the Mayans didn't know the wheel, how did they polish the crystal? Because the only way you can polish is using diamond, or another tanks maybe. So how can we respond to that? So this is amazing because the jaw you can put in and put out. And when you take photos on this, when this is activated with the light, they could see symbols like the Observatorio Chichen Itza. They have taken some UFOs, the Bigfoot, the Potala in Tibet, and many holographic images inside of this crystal. So become your head, become your mind in a crystal skull. Represents to clear yourself of all these negative images, ideas, thoughts, and become yourself in a crystal clear man with positive, manifesting the light, manifesting the things in a positive way, creating a new way to see the world. There is a beautiful Maya concept who says, if you believe, you can create. If you can create, you can manifest. If you believe, you can create. If you can create, you can manifest. That is a symbol of one of the 20 Mayan glyphs that is known with the name of Men, M-E-N, or the eagle in the dream spell of José Argüelles. So the windows still there, but now you will see that they are going up as the sun goes by, goes down, the window goes up. Look, the window is there. Up, you see now, because the sun is descending. The window is there. Close of the ring. See the window? Where is now, this is almost 6 p.m. The window is there, and this is the decapitated. That's the ball court, the symbol, the temple of the inner spiritual psychological transformation. It's no human sacrifices, it's no bones. They tried to find bones in Chichen Itza, and they found rings, they found statues. All the stories about the well, the cenote, they are many, many lies. Because one of the ways that now you know is that from specific institutions, we are not going to receive the support to be aware and to take and to have consciousness. So we need to follow the path of the inner warriors. And as Hunapu Ishbalanke, to do the transformations that we need to do through the meditations, through the different techniques, you know, but now is the time. Now is the moment. Now is the right time and space to do it when all this wonderful knowledge is coming out through all these people, through all these amazing books and writers and speakers. That is the equinox in the windows. The day of when Kukulkan appear in the pyramid, thus the ball core shows the equinox, the sunset. The ball is the sun. And the sun goes from the equinox, you know, connecting with the ball core. This is north, this is south, equinox, summer solstice. Summer solstice, fall equinox. Fall equinox, winter solstice. The ball, pok ta pok, 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 pok ta pok. That's the name that the Mayans gave to the ball court. That is the goodbye of the sun in the equinoxes. The Chacmol, one of the most beautiful sculptures, they were found by someone named Augustus Le Plongeon, 1879, at Chichen Itza, and he found 12 of these Atlantean statues. They only found in Tula, Tulan, Tule, Aztlan, Atlantida, and at Chichen Itza, because Chichen Itza was the second city founded by Lord Itzamna. The people of the Itz, the Du, Ha, the Itzais, the people of the Du, of the water. So the Itzais were there connecting with the ancient temples of Atlantis. So for me, Chichen Itza represents the cosmic university of the Mayas and is an example how, you know, the Atlanteans transmit to the Mayans through Itzamna the same sacred geometries, and they rebuild again in this Maya land to remind us our mission, our memory. We are here, yes, but we have now another big responsibility. We are the Atlanteans, all incarnated here again with one purpose: to save our planet and to save us from this process, negative process or catastrophe. And I believe with all my heart that we can do it. And my hope to be here with you is to touch your heart, is to say, we can do it. Still we are here. Still we have hope. Faith. That's why we are here. Our mission is to save our planet. Awake. Take consciousness. It's time. Still is time. Don't lose your faith. Be a warrior. Transform yourself. Now is the time. There is no in 10 years, in 2 years. What's going to happen in 2012? It's not important. What is important is now, today, I pray, say, thank you, Father, Mother, for all that we have received, for the meals, for the bread, for the wind, because I knew a new friend. And every day, bless your meals. Say greetings to your neighbors. Change your habits. Change your mind. Don't wait 2 years, or 3 years, or 10 years. Do now. Now is the future. And the future of 2012 is doing now, in this moment, not in 2 years. So warriors of light, awake. We are the same people. We came from Atlantis with that power. We need that. As I told you, this is something that we need. People with hearts. People in perfect balance between the head and the heart. science with love, technology with love, using all that you have to make harmony, balance. And I admire all the scientifics, all the science technology, but it's needed to use for well. How many centuries we have misused? How is the state of Mother Earth now? We need to reevaluate it. And each one of us makes every day a little seed of consciousness. I am sure that in 2 years, this world show a new face of consciousness. Believe me, your action, don't change people, change yourself. Imagine you are the stone, and the stone goes in the water, and it's from you who you make concentric circles and touch the heart and touch through your actions the mind of the other ones. Don't say anything. Do the actions. Make the experience alive. And people will see you, oh, wonderful. You have changed. You have changed your mind. You have changed your habits. You have changed your diet. Now you have honor for everything. Wonderful. It's not that we really want. What is Maya consciousness mean? To be in that alignment and that awareness. This is continuing with this process. Many people said that the Mayans didn't use instruments to see the sky. But this is from the Codice Trocortesiano. You see this man looking to all directions of the sky. And in the darkness of the cosmos, he has the extra vision, the third eye, and the vision to see the cosmos. This is from the Trocortesian Codex and shows two astronomers. One who is looking through this obelisk, looking to one structure who looks like a pyramid as a cross, and one woman who is sitting here, and she has an obelisk, but in the way like the Egyptians. Look, this is quite interesting. The energy is flowing down and enter to the pineal gland of the head. This overture is not a mistake because when I draw them, I saw this entrance and it's not a mistake. It's the real drawing coming from the Trocortesian Codex. And look, the head of this man, full of light. The energy and the eye, this means astronomy observation. The circle, Hunabku, the only one giver of the movement and measurement. There is another couple, there is one small old man. In the Maya, when we say teacher, we don't say teacher, we say grandpa or grandma. Abuelo, abuela, ve con el abuelo, go with the grandpa, because el abuelo, the abuela, the grandpa and the grandma is represented like, as an old man, like Ishpiyakok Ishmukane, and he's looking through this observatory, something, and he is looking through this to the glyph of the Lakin, who is the sunrise. Look the energy, how it's descending to the pineal gland, and look the energy here. How did the Mayans watch the sky with the closed eyes? It's not strange that he's watching to this marker with the closed eyes, because he's using the clairvoyance, who is represented right here. This is the clairvoyance. He's looking extra retin, and he's looking to the symbol of Muluk, image, Ben, and the symbol of the West, chicken. This is another old man using another instrument. The instrument looks like this. It's like a kind of golf stick with holes. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. He's holding and he's looking through this, the symbol Kawak, the symbol Ish, Kan, Muluk, and Ish. That's the symbol of the moon. That's the 11th number. That's the seed, Kan, Ish, Ben, Sun. So he's doing an astronomical observation through the Mayan glyphs using a specific instrument that unfortunately, I don't know what is the matter made of, but they use instruments, they use technology that is written, is drawing in the Mayan books. This one who is enlightened, you see the chakras, the pineal gland, and the third eye totally awakened, totally open, you see? And he's telling that it's going to be an eclipse of sun, half partial eclipse of sun, who is represented here with a cross, like a pyramid, and Mars is going to be in that alignment. So it's Mars symbol with the sun symbol. So the Mayans were marvelous scientific people, connecting with this amazing, you know, love and intuition to use properly to give and to love Mother Earth and to know which day is the best day to do ceremony in the Mayan calendar. Because everything comes from the cosmos to the earth. So the calendar is not doing only by men, it's doing by the cosmic energies, the cosmic and the telluric energies. That's why we are 20. The 10 fingers represent the cosmic energies, and the 10 toes represent the telluric energies. The Maya said, you are unique little vibrational beings, human beings in the Mayan concept. We are energy, vibrational beings with 20, who is the amazing account. Representing the symbolism of the ball court, this is one of the beautiful replicas that Ignacio Marquina, one brilliant architect in Mexico, he did a wonderful work all Mexico and the sites of Mexico. And this is the original way like the ball court looks like. This is the window that I show you. This is the equinoxes. There's two another with the heaven, represents the heaven, earth, and the underworld. So there are two windows here, the temple now, two windows, and two windows. The representation of the one T coming from the sky, bringing the energy of the gods, connecting in the center, represents the surface, going down to the underground. Two T's. The T is a symbol in Palenque, who is represented in the temples and means Ik. Ik is the spirit of God who represents the breath of life, the Ik. So the ball courts were connecting with the two sacred T's, one bringing down the cosmic heaven energies, connecting with the earth in the center of the rings of the ball court, and the Shivalva, the underground. This is the symbol of the ceiba tree, who represents the roots, the underworld, the trunk, the earth, and the branches, the heaven. In our cosmic organization as a human beings, the roots represents the body, the trunk represents the soul, and the branches represent our spirits. We are three, you know, father, mother, son, body, soul, spirit, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, positive, negative, neutral, sacred masculine, sacred feminine, sacred neutral. En nombre del Padre, del Hijo, del Espíritu Santo. Three forces, the pyramid, the tree, represents the cosmic law of the creation. And the seven represent the cosmic law of the organization. Okay, this is a diagram that you can see clearly that I show you first with the slide, with the first photos. This is what happened with the light in May 13. You know, this is the panel with the seven players. This is the window, the rings, the other ring here. And this is the beginning of May 13. May month, May 13, the first player, May 15, second, May 17, the third one, May 19, the fourth one, May 21, the five, 23, the six, and the seven, 25. The skull, the ring, and the window will be aligned with the light of the sun, May 29, you know, 27 and 29. And then you have seven players in the left side plus seven players in the right side. Seven plus seven is 49. Four plus nine is 13. The number of the skull is 13. And the number of the 13 represents the immortality of the soul, the immortality of the spirit. That's why we avoid it in the Western culture, because the 13 is not a bad luck number. It represents the immortality of your spirit. Your spirit is eternal, and it's light, and it's clear, and it's life forever. That's the symbol of the ball court, the consciousness shift in 2012, but it's sorry. Let's go. Okay, so next. Up four. The consciousness shift in 2012 for me, become your thoughts in light, transform yourself, be a Maya, become yourself in a chosen one. Because the only thing who can I say is, when we awake ourselves is when we are enlightened, when we arise our consciousness to the point that everything deserves honor, respect, and love. So this is the meaning here. The seven serpents represent the seven levels of energy, physical, etherical, mind, astral, mind, will, consciousness, innermost. We need to rebirth in the seven levels of energy. This is the head of the ego with the knife who represents the sun, and this is the skull talking, enlightened, and three dots in the eyebrow. One, two, three. The three forces of the universe help you to do the inner transformation. The skull is talking means life. Is not dead. The crystal skull represents the Christ, the immortality of the spirit, the human's being supreme transformation. The number 13, as I explained to you, seven players for seven players makes 49. The synthesis 4 plus 9 is 13, represents the heavens in the Mayan Cosmovision, the Osh Lahun Tiku, God's divinity inside you. Next March, we're going to have a conference in Merida about the crystal skulls, And I invite you, if you are interested in to know more about these extraordinary gifts that the Mayans left us, to represent the crystal skull, represents the crystalline, the crystallization, the crystallized, the Christ consciousness, the crystal, the clear, the cleansing, finally, the light. So this is our head. This is our crystal skull. This is the symbol that we are looking for now. This is the right moment to do it. And then if we now know that this is happening in the afternoon with the sunset, of course, in the mornings will be the opposite. So this phenomenon in the windows of the Volcor will be in the morning with the sunrise, looking to the other seven players in the morning, in the same process, May 13 to May 7, 27, 29, in the morning, and of course, with the sunset. You understand? Okay? The Pleiades is one of these aspects who many people here feels connected. And many people said, I feel connected with Pleiades. The Pleiades were called Sabkan, Sab, Rattle, Kan, Snake, the rattlesnake constellation. One of the tests or the proofs for me is in the Trocortesian Codex, and is this representation of the skull with an axe, because I found that it represented the seven sons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the big one, who could be Alcyon or could be Maya. And then again here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So there are seven sons and seven sons. And why in the ball court, precisely when in Chichen Itza is going to be the zenith, an alineation with the Pleiades constellation, the skull is represented in the Mayan book precisely with the figure of the skull connecting with the seven sons of Pleiades. There is no coincidences. The Mayans knew perfectly that the Pleiades are precisely, you know, the energy necessary to do the big transformation in our seven levels of energy. Seven suns of the Pleiades, seven chakras, 7 days of the week, seven colors in the rainbow, seven musical notes, seven inner glands. The ball court, again, seven players. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The skull, 7, 6, another 7. 7 plus 7, 49. 4 plus 9, 13. The immortality of the soul. 1 plus 3, 4. 13, 4, 52. The Pleiades cycle. 5 plus 2, 7. The number of the sacred organization in Mother Nature and ourselves. The seven chakras, the Kundalini energy, the 7 days, the seven colors, the seven musical notes. Is that a coincidence? And in the same message in the pyramid. 91 steps each side, 91 for the four sides of the pyramid, 364. 3 plus 6 plus 4, 13. 1 plus 3, 4. 13, 4, 4, 52. Pleiades cycle. 5 plus 2, 7. men's sacred number. The Mayans didn't leave us. The Mayans are here. Through many of you, the teachers are here. We were not born physically here, but we have now spiritually the contact with the Mayas. And the Mayas, I remind you, means a consciousness statement. So you could be a Maya if you study, if you meditate, if you transform yourself. Maya means a consciousness statement. Do you want to be a Maya? Now is the time. Work for that with heart. And make your thought crystal. I am going to do the last part of this conference. We're going to do some Mayan mantras. You like to sing some Mayan mantras? But in this land, it was difficult to find the testimony or the knowledge about how can we sing Mayan mantras, okay? So I found through meditations that each sacred name of the gods represents a mantra. Now we're going to do five of them. The first one is going to be Hunabku. No? Hunabku. Hunabku is the only one giver of the measurement and time, represent the cosmic creation. Then the second one is going to be the sacred name of the Divine Mother in the Maya, Ixchel. Ixchel, Ixchel. And then the third one is going to be the sacred name of the serpent of light, Kukulkan. Kukulkan, Kukulkan. And then it's going to be another one who is connected with the universal consciousness, who is with the mantra OEL. And then we close with the mantra of the sun, sharing with all the planet, with all the beings, with all of you, all these beautiful energies from the heart. And it's the mantra Kin, 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 Kin. It's calling the sun, the energy of the sun. Okay? So take a comfortable position. And close your eyes. Breathe in. Breathe out. This moment, imagine that from the source of the sun, the light of the sun, this energy is coming down, the divine energy of the God of the sun, the golden energy is touching your seventh chakra, cleanse your mind, your thoughts, the brain, the neurons, with this beautiful light arising the consciousness. Now pass to the throat, cleanse your throat, your free chakra, the speaking area. Now pass to the heart, to your sun in your body. Now we'll pass to the solar plexus. The solar plexus, emotional center. Then we pass to the second chakra. And then we connected with the coccyx, the first chakra, the sexual first and second chakra, connecting with the earth. Now we grounded the energy, the heart of the earth. Now we connected with Lord Hunabku. Out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Look how the light is in perfect alignment. You are connected with Hunabku. Now, we are going to concentrate in our mother, the divine sacred feminine, Ixchel, Mother Rainbow, Mother of the Light, Mother of the Childbirds, Mother of the Medicine, Mother of the Rivers, Mother of the Mountains. In this moment, you can ask to Mother Ixchel, heal whatever you need to be healed. Any part of your body, your soul, emotions, mind. When you pray with love, everything is possible. So we concentrate and we invoke our divine inner mother and the mother of the earth, Ixchel. Help us, guide us, heal to us. Then we do the mantra, breath in. Mother, receive my energy. Send to the heart of the earth. Breathe in and breathe out. Bless the heart of Mother Earth. Bless the earth. Breathe in, breathe out. 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 In perfect balance with Mother Earth, the surface, the energy of Kundalini the heart of the earth. Now we'll invoke the Shiva Shakti, the Kundalini energy, Kukulkan. So align your back perfectly in order that when you say the mantra, the Kundalini energy from the earth arise through your seventh chakras, connecting with the heart. Serpent of light, Kukulkan, Quetzalcoatl, precious serpent of light, we invoke you. We invite you to arise in our back, in our spine, to bring us the balance again in our seven chakras. Breath in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Look how your seven chakras in golden light, in perfect alignment, in golden light, all of them awaken, reactivating. All this energy goes to the heart, who is the nest of the serpent. Kukulkan, Quetzalcoatl. is in your heart forever and ever. Now we call with the mantra and all the universal consciousness in ourselves to all the spirits of this planet, for our planet Earth, and expressing love to all the sentient beings, compassion and love, happiness, harmony, healing, light. We resonate now with the planet and with all the elements of life in the different kingdoms. Breathe in. Expand your love, expand your light to all the beings, to all the kingdoms. Send love and light, honored, healing, abundance, harmony, and all the beautiful things we have in our hearts with a consciousness, with awareness that now we have. Now we are going to do the final mantra. With the light of the sun, the mantra Kin, and imagine that now we are going to fulfill from this place to all the places, to all the countries, to all the world with golden light, ourselves in beautiful cocoons of light, and every cell in every molecule in ourselves will shine to the golden, in golden light, and all the planet will be in golden light, in harmony with the energy of the sun. Okay, now we're going to invoke Father Sun.
Tin 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 t
Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in and breathe out, breathe in and breathe out. Listen to the drum with the beat of your heart, connecting with the heart of the sky, the heart of the earth. And share all this light with all the beings, with all the people, your family, your home, your country, the world, the planet. We are one, one heart, one home, one human race. The cosmic creator of the universes is in our hearts, is our sun, is our life, is where the blood, the spirit is within us. Never forget who you are. Never forget the words that Father, Son, heart of the sky, said one day to the Mayas, my children, my daughters, my sons. One day, I did a sacrifice to send you to incarnate in the planet. Because I want you to experience the human incarnation, and I want you to know what is the correct balance and to incarnate the consciousness of love. But one day, all of you, my children, all of you, my sons and my daughters, will come back to me. One day, all of you will come back to my heart. And in my heart, you will have a space with an eternal happiness that never ends. That day, my daughters and my sons will come soon. Now, experience what you need to experience. I love you forever and ever. Breath in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Open your eyes. From my heart to your heart, in La Quech, to all of you. Gracias.